Someone came through 25 years ago and planted all these trees and got them growing, got them on the right foot, did the site prep, picked the seedlings, the genetics, put it out here, and then they followed through with fertilization, maybe some herbaceous weed control, put a lot of money and a lot of time and effort into getting this forest growing. So when we come out here, it's our job to capitalize on what they started. My name is Rusty Cobb. I'm the timber marketing manager for the Southern Zone of the Coastal Resource Unit. Today, we're on a pretty much a typical southern logging job. And what you will see here is we actually have two loaders. For most crews will have one loader, one feller buncher, which cuts the trees down, and then one skidder, which you see behind me is the big green machine that drags the trees up to the loader to be processed. And this crew will do probably make about 85 loads a week. They probably could do more if they pushed it and if they had the trucking capacity, but right now that's their comfort zone, is about 85 loads a week. There are a lot of crews that work in the 60-65 load per week production area, and that's probably, I would say, typical of most crews in the region, but this crew just added an extra piece of equipment to kind of up their production. So on a typical operation in the South, we have a feller buncher, which is a machine, can be tracked, or usually it's rubber tired, has a big saw disc on the front, and it fells the trees in bunches and lays them on the ground. And then the skidder is a large tractor with a grapple on the back that will come by and grab those bunches of wood and drag them up to the loader. And then the loader is this machine, these machines that you see behind me with the big knuckle boom on them. And it will pick those up and then run those through a saw and cut them off at the various lengths needed to maximize the value of those logs. And then it will load them onto a trailer, which is then carried by the set out man on a set out truck to be dropped and ready for a road truck semi to take them to the mill. This first pile of logs is an example of a pile of export logs that have been cut, ready to load on a truck. There is no butt diameter minimum on these. There is only a top end diameter minimum of 8 inches, and the length, as we've talked about, has to be around 19 foot 5 inches. So this is our most valuable product out here. This is sorted, or cut, sorted, and ready to load onto a trailer and shipped to Jacksonville, to be put into containers and shipped over to China. This is a sort of a pile of chip-n-saw logs, tree length. So these have at least a butt diameter, minimum butt diameter of 9 inches, and they have to be at least 25 foot long, and then the top end diameter can be no less than 5 inches. And they have to be very straight, and the butts have to be trimmed up nice and flush. So this is our next product. This is what we would call here in this area, Kennerwood. Kennerwood can apply to different products, different specs in other regions, but for here, in this part of the world, this is what we would call canter log. And again, they have to have a 5-inch top minimum. They have to be straight. They have butts have to be cut flush. Have to be pretty defect free, and very straight. Not perfect, but pretty straight. These logs were, for whatever reason, not long enough to make a 25 foot tree length chip and saw. So they were bulked into 16 foot, 6 inch lengths that will pay the same price as a chip and saw, but it just kept the wood from going into the pulpwood pile, and it gives us a chip and saw price for something that is pulpwood length. This is a pile of double bunk pulpwood. As you can see, some of it's got good diameter, but we can see defect through carnosium, rust, which was a disease that infected this and caused uncontrolled growth, and has just really cannot make a good solid wood product out of that for chip and saw or saw timber. So, but it makes plenty of paper and other pulp products. And then also this log, while it's good size, it's got really large knots here. The sawmills do not like that because it doesn't make a good a good solid board. When you have those knots in there, you have weak spots. So this was at the top of the tree. So, but it still makes a very good pulp wood. And then you have smaller pieces here that just were basically smaller trees with a fork in them that you could not make a solid wood product out of. Then we have some other wood over here that's busted up tops with lots of knots and things in them. But as long as they are at least 15 feet, 15, 16 feet to a 3-inch diameter top, then we can maximize the value of that wood rather than leaving it in a pile to rot. Behind me, Rayonier prefers this for, Rayonier Advanced Materials prefers this for handling and other reasons. So most of our wood to them will be tree length. We do not cut it and put it into two bunks on a trailer like the double bunk wood. Same basic spec, needs to be at least 3 inches in, on the top size. And then tree length is generally, I'd say, 25 foot or longer, and to fit through the bolsters. And then you can see here, even though it's a small tree, even if it were larger, the crook in this wood wouldn't be acceptable. So even if it was a larger tree, it would still go as pulp wood because of the form in there. But for the most part, this is, you start off pulp wood, you're looking at smaller, younger trees usually, that just were overgrown in the canopy, and smaller wood, it just never really got full size. And then also, as we've shown, you can have larger wood that just has deformities or branches, knots, things of that nature. So here we have a log to simulate exactly how it could be merchandised. This first length here to this flag is 19 and a half feet, or 19 foot 5 inches. If it's sawed right there, this log is of good quality, and it's well over 8 inches in diameter. So this would be an export log. This would be the highest value use for this particular log. Then what we have left, we have another section that is 19 foot 5 inches. So we could get another export log out. So therefore we're maximizing the use out of it rather than taking that length and doing, say, a tree length chipping saw and getting several dollars less. The crew would actually take this, cut another export log out. We can't quite get 19 and a half feet to where the 8-inch top is. So we're going to carry it on out past 25 feet, which is where the red marker is at the end, toward the end down here. This log will be 25 feet to above a 5-inch top, so it will be a chipping saw log. It's just not quite 8 inches at 19 and a half feet. Because this is a tree length product, we can actually leave on this extra section here and get paid the same amount per ton for that by leaving that piece on. And if you do that across a whole stand of trees, that value adds up. So we just have to work with the logger and get their eye and get them trained on what our products need to be in order to maximize the value of every log just like this.